Good afternoon, everyone. In the last class, in the last video, we had studied about the multimedia, what is multimedia, the definitions of multimedia, the types of media, and also regarding some multimedia networks. And today here, we'll be studying something about the multimedia applications. Well, where do we use multimedia in the real life? That is what this chapter says as it is simple. So in the multimedia applications, again, we have broadly classified into three types, that is interpersonal communication, interactive applications over the internet, and entertainment applications. And we have some subclasses in these all the three types. The first thing we will move on to interpersonal communications. Coming to interpersonal communications, as we know, most of the communications happens through voice and using the speech itself. And this is a vague diagram, a simple block diagram of speech only, that is where we will be using the telephonic conversation. In the telephonic conversation, as I already told, it may be one-to-one, that is using the telephones, or it may be the conference or the call that we will be using, that is also again using the telephones. If we are using some conference calls, in order to connect the people, that is three or more, two or more people, we will be using a central unit called as the audio bridge. Next, we have the telephony over internet. That is, you people very well know that we can make calls using the telephone. And that is what this shows, the telephony over internet. In order to have the internet connection, you can either have the internet service provider or a central site or campus line or an enterprise-wide network, as we discussed in the data network in the previous section. And next type of interpersonal communications is using image only, that is using the facsimile example. It is an example where we use only image. As you know, the facsimile is nothing but the fax. In general, it is called as fax. We have a fax machine, and every fax machine has its own number, just like the telephones that we have. So you will make a certain call similar to the telephone, but instead of speaking on the fax machine, we will be sending some images that will be scanned from the one end and then will be printed on the other end. That is what this is a simple block diagram of a facsimile example. And next, when you are coming to text or image or video, you can use the email transfer. That we know, as when I come to email, it requires the internet connection. Using the email, you can transfer whatever the text file you want, or you can convert some into PDFs, or you can compress the videos and send through it and everything. And here below is a small format of the email page that we'll have. And next, we have the next application where we have text and images. That is, this actually comes into multimedia, where we are combining two different media types, that is text and image. And one of the applications that involve both text and images is CSCW, that is computer supported cooperative working. So in this computer supported cooperative working, you have a network here, and to the network there are many computers that are connected, and all the computers will have a screen here, that is called as a shared whiteboard. So whatever the changes you make on the shared whiteboard here, it will be moving on to the change notification section. And when the change is indicated, this update control part will update that change in all the other systems that are connected here. And next we have the application that involves the speech and video. As we are generally using this, the speech and video is nothing but a two-party video telephone call or some multi-conferences calls and everything. Here this is a block diagram of a two-party video telephone call. This is a network here, PSTN or internet or ISDN or LAN or enterprise, or whatever the connection you want to have. And we have two PCs on the other end, just to see the people on the other end. As you know, in the conference calls, we'll have two windows on the screen, one smaller window in which we will be visible, and in the other larger video where the other person who is speaking is also visible. And next, this is video conferencing using an MCO. That is, if you are in the conference call, there are more than two people involved, then we'll have a multi-point control unit here. Whatever the data, for example, I call this system as A, this is B, and this is C. If the information is sent by user A, that information will be first received by the MCU, and then MCU will transmit it to both B and C. So MCU acts as the intermediate unit which supports the video conferencing here. And next we have this is also a communication, sorry, video conferencing, where we have more than two people involved. But here, instead of a MCU like in the previous case, we have a multicasting network. That is, we don't have a MCU. The internet itself transfers the information to other things. Other users. Now, this is called as a multi-party video conferencing. See, for example, in a very high industries or in some colleges that we can see, we have a separate video conferencing room with all the systems, the video cameras, audio systems and everything to record the classrooms. Also have some meetings with the people in the other campuses. So this is such an arrangement is shown in the block diagram. This is a separate video conferencing studio, this is a separate video conferencing studio, and this is the same. So all these three studios are connected through the ISDN broadband networks. And this is some higher end, here we'll be using some higher end video on the audio camera. So the mere PSTN or a LAN network cannot be used here. So we'll move on to some ISDN or broadband networks. Next is interactive applications over the internet network schematic. What does this internet applications say is just how the files will be loaded from a server to the computer. Just when you type something onto Google, the network will retrieve it and it will send to n number of servers, and the servers will search for the corresponding information and it will respond back to the PCs. This is a simple block diagram of that. And this is the hypertext linkage pages. For example, if you are searching for some, if you open some university pages, there will be n number of links, for example, admissions or contactors or some department sections, where if you click on certain link, the new page will be opened. So these are the linkages that are given. Those links are called as hyperlinks and the text are called as hypertext. And next we have the entertainment applications. In entertainment applications, we have movie on demand and interactive television. As you know, this movie on demand, you will just contact the server regarding which movie or the video you want to watch, and then the server will respond you back with that particular movie or video. That is for the requesting thing. That is when you are requesting, I want this particular video to be placed, we will use a low bitrate interaction channel. And if the server is responding back to you with the video, as the video is of higher data, we'll be using the high bitrate channel. And interactive television is when you are your television at home can be used for some entertainment or some shopping applications and the rest of the thing. And this is the time scale diagram of the mod or n mod, where the n number of requests for the same movie are served at the very same particular time, as you can see here. So the detailed explanations will be explained in the class, and again there will be certain quizzes given on this particular multimedia application that you need to solve it. And for today's class, this is it. And again, the PPT share with you people, you can download it. Okay, any doubts, just post it on the discussion forum. We'll be always ready to comment. Thank you so much.